down to the splendor, the spectacle, the sparkling sensation, where the romance, the comedy, and the thrill of Disney fantasies come to electric life.
And as our friend Jiminy said, welcome. Welcome to the Disney Nerds Podcast, a place each week where like-minded people get together to discuss all things Disney. We'll help you get your Disney fix on. Here we go.
A Magic Kingdom proudly presents, in a million points of musical light, the magical worlds of Disney.
Hello and welcome to show number 495 of the Disney Nerds Podcast. Hey guys, how's it going? And welcome back to the show. This is Ed, and on this week's show, well, we're going to be taking some rides in Walt Disney World. As you know, I've been lucky enough to be down in Florida for the summer, and I've been going in and out of the parks, and I've got a couple different rides for you for today. The first one's going to be Guardians of the Galaxy. I think we're then going to get over to Animal Kingdom, and It's Tough to Be a Bug. I think then we're going to listen to the Epcot fireworks show, which we did right after our meetups last Saturday. And then to finish it up, there's going to be a small clip at the end that I think's hilarious as hell. We ate at Andy's backyard barbecue, and some of the audio things that go on during dinner were hilarious. And I've got a little clip for you. Okay, so without further ado, the first clip is going to be Guardians of the Galaxy over at Epcot. I made the virtual queue at home in New Smyrna, so it was like an hour and 20 minutes away. And wouldn't you know it, at 7 o'clock in the morning, it said I had like 600 and something minutes. And as I was getting ready to leave at 9, it said I had like 35 minutes. So we learned that it didn't matter when you get called, you'll be able to get on the ride afterwards. And that's what happened for me. So here we go, Guardians of the Galaxy. Hey guys, this is Ed, and it's time to take a ride in the parks. We're going to be riding Guardians of the Galaxy over at Epcot, so come along with us. Enjoy. Wow, we turns are really loud.
Everyone, thank you. Greetings, Terrans. I am Nova Prime Irani Rayan, commander of the Nova Corps. On behalf of all Xandarians, I hope you have enjoyed exploring the wonders of Xandar. As you have seen, your world and ours were born of the same moment, one which you refer to as the Big Bang. As such, we are all galactic neighbors in a vast universe which we and countless others share. For you to travel to Xandar would take 2.5 million years, assuming you had a ship that could fly at the speed of light. So we decided to come to you. But even we could not have reached you so easily were it not for the Cosmic Generator, an advanced piece of Xandarian technology that creates jump points, artificial tunnels that act as shortcuts, linking distant points in space. It is our desire to share this wondrous technology with your people so that together we might explore new worlds and create a brighter tomorrow. And now, as the culmination of the wonders of Xandar, you will be teleported to a Nova ship above your planet for a demonstration of the Cosmic Generator. I trust you will find it an unforgettable experience.
Welcome, people of Epcot. Epcotters. Epcotians. Citizens of Epcot. Does anyone know what they call themselves? What? Someone needs to tell me when I'm on. Welcome, Epcot Terrans. I am Centurion Tal Merrick, and we're just about ready to teleport you up to the ship for the demonstration. As you're about to enter a secure Nova area, I must ask you to put away your Terran communication devices at this time. Recording of any type is strictly prohibited. I am very serious about this. Now, please step forward into the chamber. You're gonna love this.
I need to alert Nova Prime.
I've been watching Terrans for
Ulysses has failed.
Wait, whoa, we didn't even know there was a test.
He's got the cosmic generator. He's creating a new jump point.
Jump point to where?
Not where. When?
So good of you, jump point.
It's going back to the dawn of time.
Dawn of time, why?
To erase the error.
Well, that doesn't sound good.
Your time is over.
Our power is down, and I've got to get these Terrans onto evacuation shuttles.
I got it. I reprogrammed the shuttles to follow them through the jump port.
Wait,
what?
Look, they're our only chance of keeping track of that whack job until we get the cosmic generator back. Piece of cake.
What?
They're escaping. Where's escaping?
The odds are impossible.
Yep.
But it's our only shot. Good luck.
Are you sure you can control it?
Come on, it's me. We got this.
We're all toast.
First it was cake, now there is toast. This plan is making me so hungry.
Terrence, listen up. You need to make your way to the evacuation shuttles now.
We'll follow with the fleet if we get our power back.
I mean, when we get our power back.
I'm off now. This plan of the Guardians doesn't stand a chance.
What?
Is it on? What did I just say? You need to tell me what I'm on.
Are you Terrence still there? Everything is under control. We're rebooting our subsystems and we'll have the power back soon. We do hope you enjoyed your brief visit with us. Over and out.
Could this day get any worse?
Thank you. Have you done this before?
Nope.
It's fun.
Oh, yeah.
It's fun.
We have a daughter who's too little to ride, so my husband went first. He was like, it was awesome.
And doing the switch?
Yeah,
nice.
Yeah. So, I love all of this.
You're going to love this.
It's an honorary title. They're not coming with us.
I see. It is meaningless.
Well, welcome to the Guardians of the Galaxy. Well, where is it?
Only two reactions. It's awesome, or I'm going to get sick. Everybody looks in on this.
Welcome back to Epcot. Please gather all personal belongings and exit the Star Jumper. The Nova Corps thanks you for your service.
The girl that wrote it with me was hilarious. She was a mother from a family of five, so she was like the extra one. She got to ride with me. She loved it. She had a great time. That was her kind of yelling. But it was Blast. Guardians is always great. I totally recommend it. Okay, so the next ride I'm going to bring you is surprisingly one of the loudest screaming rides I think you're going to experience in Walt Disney World. And Animal Kingdom, that says a lot, considering you've got Everest, and you've got Dinosaur, and Flight of Avatar, but I stand by that. So as you listen in, you'll hear And I think I brought you this audio, or an audio from It's Tough to Be a Bug before. I did this one about a week ago, and nothing's changed. The show is exactly the same. And like I said, this is one of the most Scream-inspiring shows that they have in Disney World. Let's just say it makes your kids grow up very quickly. So, here we go. Enjoy.
Hey guys, take a ride with the Disney Nerd. We're on It's Tough to Be a Bug. Enjoy the pre-show, and then we'll go right in.
Your favorite row and come all the way down, fill in all the spaces. Please don't climb over anybody. As a reminder, this is a 3D show, so all of our seats are good ones. Moments, our cast, the Bugs, will present their show. But before then, I do have a couple of reminders for you. The first one is that our show does feature loud noises, darkness, and some special effects that might be too intense for some viewers. If for any reason you'd like to leave the theater, make your way to either side, and a cast member will assist you getting to the exit doors on your left. Second, as courtesy to our Bug cast, to all of those sitting around you, we ask that there be no photos, videos, cell phone use, eating, or drinking while you're in the theater. And now, on behalf of the millions and billions of bugs around the world, we're happy to present It's Tough to to be a bug.
Throughout today's performance, please refrain from buzzing, stinging, and pollinating. And no chirping. Thank you. And now, put your wings together for the host of our show, everyone's favorite act, Lick!
Fireflies, up here. Over here. Way over. A little more. This. Perfect. Oh, and hi. Hello, and welcome. Welcome to our show. You know, we've been doing this act for over 300 million years. And with bugs making up more than 80% of the animal world, we're the biggest cast of them all. Still, you guys just don't seem to see us. So that's why we gave you the special bug eyes. Now, go ahead, put them on. Neat, huh? Yeah, now you're all honorary bugs. So on with the show. That's why we've developed some amazing survival techniques. For instance, deep in the jungles of South America, there's a bug. Well, technically, he's an orangutan, you see. And Shelby, I really hate when you do that. I hate.
Oh, I'm sorry, Flick.
Where was I? Yes, Chili and Tarantulas, my friend Chili here, throw poison pearls at their enemies with deadly accuracy.
I never miss.
This is probably one of my favorites.
Paul! Come on, keep on coming! Chili's on a roll!
Hey, what are you guys trying to pull?
Watch it! This is not my end! Hold still!
Back off!
In case you hadn't noticed, alright?
Humans! What makes a fool of Chili, man? Come back here and die like a bug!
Alright, well. Our next guest is a soldier termite who defends his mound by spraying intruders with acid. That's right. Acid. Welcome now. He's buff, he's ready, and he's... Oh. And he's ruining our set. We have other shows to do.
I am a mean defensive machine. I am the termite
angle.
Oh no. I detect more intruders.
No! They're not intruders. No. They're honorary bugs.
Oh, no. Intruders must be terminated. No exceptions. I need more ammo. I'll be back.
Oh, is everybody all right up there? Oh. I hope that none of you are allergic to acid. Oh my. Best to move along. All right, our next guest. Let's meet the silent but deadly member of the bug world, the stink bug.
All right, ready, Flick.
All right, hold your second.
Let it rip, Claire.
Hey, come back here, man!
Oh, I'm sorry.
out of my sight.
Hey, bring in the evidence. Friends don't exterminate. Friends do.
Still don't get it?
Well, then watch this. You humans have always seen us as monsters.
If you had your way, you
would destroy us all.
You never will, because we outnumber you 200 million to one. Maybe it's time you honorary bugs got a taste of your own medicine. What? You're still alive? This means war!
Okay guys, thanks for joining the Disney Nerds on a Scream Fest attraction. See you on the next ride. Okay guys, so next what we're going to listen to is the Epcot Forever show. As you all know, Harmonious was taken out and we're back to Forever, which is an okay show. They don't have any of the water skiers, jet skiers, or any of that type of stuff. They do have some lasers, they have the fireworks, of course, and I think they've got what the best part of it is a good soundtrack. You get to hear all of the old Epcot attractions, rides, shows, things like that. You get to hear a little different pieces of those. So that's very, very cool. This was after our Saturday night meetup in July. This was a really fun meetup. Thank you, everybody, for coming along. Next show, we're going to do a trip report show. So 496, you'll definitely hear a lot more details about this meetup and different things we did and such like that. Okay, guys. So here we go. Epcot Forever. Take it away.
Is at the heart of all creation. Take it easy on me.
You guys want to stop or keep walking?
Let's walk up
there. Okay. Yeah, actually, this is a nice little avenue right here.
It's not packed. This is great.
Want to go up here?
Yeah.
Get past this tree. Thank you.
Have you seen this one?
Thank you.
Okay, guys, for our last cut of this evening of Sounds from the Parks, what we're going to do is bring you literally 30 seconds from lunch we had the other day. Jimmy and his daughter Caitlin and cousin Mark and I ate at Andy's Barbecue Roundup, or I think that's the name of it. Anyway, it's a new restaurant in Hollywood Studios that is exclusively barbecue, and it's one of those pay one price type of deals. So you're paying, I think it was $45 maybe, plus or minus. And that gave you the appetizers, gave you the main course, and it gave you a dessert also. Really, really fun. I mentioned earlier how next week's show is going to be our trip report show. Guaranteed to hear more details about this place. However, one of the coolest things that was going on is as you're eating, every so often Ham would come on with announcements. And one of the announcements, of course, is that Andy's coming. And here's what happens when Andy comes. See if you can hear it. That was so hilarious when that happened. And when you look around the room, every woman, man, child was still as care as possible. Of course, you had some spill through sounds and things like that. But for the most part, in a restaurant that crowded, it was silent. So fun. Very, very cool. Definitely one of the extra ambiances that you get with this restaurant. Definitely very cool. Okay, guys. So that's it for show number 495. I hope you had a good time coming along in a couple rides with the Disney Nerds. This is Ed, and for all of my Disney Nerd co-hosts, thanks for listening, and we'll see you next week. Bye-bye. Sivaco! I had a thought, and I looked up to see. The sign read the park, she's closed today. E-tickets don't work here, no more anyway. Where every day's a magic day to be free, you see. It's a nice day when you wake up in Disneyland. It's a nice day should you wake up in Disneyland. Disneyland. It's a nice day should you wake up in Disneyland.